Why is my... These aren't showing
up. Oh, and that was one of the maps I was going to buy.
I'm supposed to be like the cutest Michael Myers ever.
Oh, no, you made Dave leave. Something strange. Come with us and you will see. It's our town of Halloween. This is Halloween. This is Halloween. Pumpkin scream in the dead of night. This is Halloween. Everybody make a scene. Trick or treat. Tell your neighbors how you die of fright. It's our town. Everybody's playing. Pop a 40 and check your rollies. Slice a pumpkin and check your treats. And drink your NyQuil or you're going to end up like me. I'm a little stuffy right now. There's a lot of phlegm going on. It's been a very hard month. But I think it's been a very good month. A lot of cool stuff has been happening on this channel. That's because, why? I'm Peppo the Dude. And that's how I try to do every year on this channel. And I hope you enjoyed everything I had to offer. And now as we cap off the end of October, the best month of the year anyway, I thought, what better pod to have than a Halloween pod? So happy Halloween-y. This is
Halloween, this is Halloween. Just about when I was about to sing it, too.
I love it.
Yeah, I had to do it. So, without further ado, who's joining me for this Halloween podcast? Well, the returning Amish fellow.
Oh, hold on. My computer just went screwy. Greetings, denizens of the internet. Happy Halloween.
I don't know if it's Halloween for you or you're going to rob me. What the hell?
So I got my little Link hat here and my mask from Watch Dogs.
Yeah, that's what I thought. That's so cool. I like it. It's good improvisation, but honestly, if you were on the street and I was taking my little princess to go get candy, I'd probably beat the shit out of you if you came with it. But it doesn't matter because at the end of the day, even if you are all dressed up. We've been spending most of our lives living in an Amish paradise. And he's not the only one joining me. Our good buddy, he won't be on camera because, you know, the three of us are already so good looking. You only need us. But he's still here anyway. Give it up for...
What is up, yo?
And
I love this song.
I know. And
I used to love that show, man.
Now here's the cool thing, because this isn't just a Halloween podcast. This is going to be a lot of fun, because it's all four of us again, the first time since my birthday in August. But also, I didn't think I'd have another face reveal on the channel, but here we are. What better way to cap off the Halloween podcast than with a face reveal? Because joining me and doing a face reveal, when the world is loud, follow her whisper, Alithia's whisper, Sarah.
And I am burdened with glorious purpose.
Hi guys, what's up? There
she is! Oh, I love those goggles up top. Those are awesome.
I love this costume so much.
I wish mine would have worked. I spent $5 on this shit, and it didn't fucking work.
Oh, wow. Five whole dollars.
Well, I mean, I did get these, too. It's because of the damn thing. It cuts it off. Right here is fine. But as soon as I put it on, it's like, oh. Fuck. All right. So, happy Halloween, everyone. I know we haven't done any pods since September. The last pod we did, we talked about video game violence, and that was me, Sarah, and Dave, which I think I speak for the three of us when we want to say that was a blast. So it's good to be back. We have a lot more planned in November. It's just this month we had so many other things going on the channel, so go check it out. A lot of cool things. And Forrest has become a ghost. His face no longer exists. We mourn. R.I.P.
You got lost in the trees.
Yes, he's bad. Sorry, periodically the trees will be disappearing this week because I'm a little bit under the weather. You know, you mentioned Amish Pepsi. I'm gonna ask you to back up to that for one really quick second. As you see, I do have a different background behind me right now. I am currently at home visiting family. I had to go from where I am to where they are due to a loss in the family. So if I'm in and out during this podcast, I am actively trying to do my best to help with stuff.
Well, if he's out more than twice, we'll just fire him and send Ghostface out.
We'll be holding auditions.
So yeah, we got a lot of stuff coming in November, a lot of cool stuff going on there. And this month, to cap it off, we're ending it with a Halloween pot and a lot of flack, because he's under the weather, I'm under the weather, Sarah's over the weather. It's a pretty great time here.
I was almost blown away by the weather.
Oh, yeah. There you go, yeah.
Dave has been dealing with hurricane after hurricane, but he's so good.
Nature's baiting him out. This
year. It was such a flop, I love it. Dave, there was like nothing. It's like getting sunny right now.
Well, Dave, the weather...
No, but like, it's going to be so bad.
Hey, Dave, the weather is just going through a bipolarness right now. It threw one hurricane at you, and then it was like, you know, so nice you had to do it twice, and both times it was, so don't call it, don't expect a third.
It's probably going to be like, oh, what did you say? I'll turn it right around.
It's just Mother Nature's time of the month, okay? Give her a break.
Alrighty, so to kick this off, you know, you saw some of us with costumes, and then you saw Dave just sitting there all boring, like, you know.
How dare you, Dave.
Now we're going to talk about past costumes. What's everyone's favorite past costume? Let's just talk about costume. Does anyone have a favorite costume they've had during Halloween, or what's one you remember from being a kid?
I remember... There's two that I remember very, very, very fondly. Well, one fondly and one not so fondly. My sister and I were in a local production of Willy Wonka. And
oh my gosh.
We were cast as Oompa Loompas. So.
That should have been my job.
Well, in all fairness, at that point, my sister was probably. Not quite where she is now. I'm bringing in at a shy 4'11 and a half, but...
Oh, we're the same height. That's crazy.
But... Yeah, I remember that, and that orange stage makeup was the bane of my existence. So much so, it stayed in my pores, not for days, not for weeks. This brother looked like he had mad Oompa disease going on for a couple of months. Like, people didn't think that Trump looks orange. I was a whole nother breed.
You were orange before it was popular.
Yeah, I was orange before it was
orange
popular.
Orange is the new forest.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
And there was this other one when I was younger, probably... fifth or sixth grade, I had just crossed over into Boy Scouts and we were doing our Halloween party. Now, my family didn't have a whole ton of money, but I had the bright idea. I wanted to go to this little Halloween party that we were putting together as Sasuke Uchiha from Naruto.
Oh my gosh.
So, in my grandparents' basement somewhere, I have this, martial arts uniform with just a homemade Sasuke outfit with the Uchiha crest on the back.
Oh man. Picks or it didn't happen.
And there was one more that I wore constantly. It was more than just a costume for me. Back many moons ago, we talked in the Quidditch Champions trailer reaction about how I had this Harry Potter costume, actually his Quidditch robe, and I would wear it all the time when I was playing Harry Potter in the Quidditch World Cup back in the day on the game.
Yeah.
Those are probably my most memorable costumes.
So, for probably the first, I want to say, 8 years of my life, I was the same thing every year for Halloween. You can imagine, I was the prettiest princess in all the land. I didn't start changing up costumes until I was probably, like, 9 or 10. I remember I did an Egyptian costume 1 year. I really didn't start getting into costumes until I became an adult. My favorite costume that I did recently was probably not last year, but the previous year. I was Beetlejuice before the movie, the sequel came out and everything. I loved that costume, and I found a makeup tutorial on how to do Beetlejuice makeup online, and I did that, and I loved that costume. That was probably one. That one, and then I also was Moxie from Borderlands 1 year, too. That was probably the first time I actually went all out for a costume, and I loved that costume. And then, of course, this one is probably my next favorite as well, so.
I don't remember too much about my childhood.
Well, I know it was like 60 years ago, but try.
Oh,
so sorry, that was an exaggeration. 55 years ago.
I know this is, I don't know, blasphemy, but I don't really do much for Halloween. But I remember wearing them. A Jason.
My brother, Anakin.
It was nice.
I love you.
It was nice. I mean, it's kind of cliche that I did dress up as Jason when I was a kid. Get that out. I know.
At least when you're a kid, you're super. I guess age really does knock the good shit out of you.
You remember the gangsters issue that we had when we were living in Connecticut that I talked in another pod?
Yeah.
Think about our past, and, well, one of the Halloweens, I think this is my best time because it was, like, thrown in their face. The people that were giving us a hard time, they have this specific style, and they would always have, like these keys that they would flop around while they're walking. So, on Halloween, we walk down the street from them, wearing exactly what they do, and dressing. We're dressing the way they do, and acting the way they do.
Oh, my God. Hold up, guys, before we move on. I gotta make sure we're recording.
Were you not recording the whole time?
No, that's a trick. I'm just fucking with you.
No, you
treat. Yeah.
You sure you weren't a theater kid?
It's the biggest piece of dog shit.
Forrest is the one who said I wasn't into theater. I still remember Mr. Starnes, she knows who I'm talking about, always wanting me to be in plays and stuff. So, my favorite costumes. I don't know about favorites, but I can tell you the earliest one I remember. I must have been like 4 or 5, and it was like a lion costume. I thought it was the coolest thing because it was your whole body. And, like, you were wearing this lion thing. It was so cool. I don't have any pictures with it. I know I went as a clone trooper 1 year. I had a mask, had a cool outfit. That was cool. One of the guns, which was, like, exactly from the Clone Wars show. So that was cool. Probably my worst costume. It wasn't even really a costume. I had the Dracula cape, and my mom did some makeup. I'll show the picture at the end of this. You can decide if it's cute or terrible. I think I went maybe as Captain Jack Sparrow 1 year, which I thought was cool. And then I spent the rest of the year pretending I was Captain Jack Sparrow. So I had such an imagination. If I found a stick, it was either a lightsaber, a sword, or a wand. And let me tell you something. Voldemort came back for me. There was a lot more than 8 books when I was a kid. You know. God, I had an imagination, man. I did a crossover between Harry Potter and Lord of the Rings. It was crazy. My last costume, this was when I was 19 years old, yes. Having a costume when you're 19 isn't bad. Going trick-or-treating when you're 19, a little bit different. So me and my buddy Steven, and I'll show that picture because I have that. I had on, I think, a little cape, and I put on one of those shitty skulls from Walmart, and I grabbed a lightsaber, and I was like, dude, let's go get some fucking candy. he grabbed a Walking Dead box, and he was like, I'll just put this on. I'm like, dude, you got to be more creative than that. So I took it off, and I put two eyes in it, a little face. And made it look like he like it was an actual costume, because I wanted us to get candy. And we went up and down the neighborhood, because we're outside of, you know, where we actually live. So no one would know us. So we were able to get away with this without humiliation. We actually got some candy. And all this stemmed from him saying, dude, there's no way we'd get any candy. We're too old. I was like, dude, you bet your ass we'll get candy. You want to bet? I threw some shit on. I did that thing with the box for him. And that was the last one besides me buying Michael Myers mask, which I mainly bought for, just for kids coming to go trick-or-treating, which everywhere I've moved to, no one's come trick-or-treating. So if I could ever choose a costume now, whether it be for Halloween or anything, it'd definitely be Deadpool. I would love
to have a Deadpool.
But, they could call me Fatpool. I mean,
be another variant, right?
Exactly. We talked about our favorite costumes. Let's talk about our favorite memories. What's a favorite memory with trick-or-treating or Halloween that you guys have? Let's have Sarah go first this time.
Ooh, ladies first, okay. I think, so when I was younger, my family always had a tradition kind of where on Halloween, the first part of the day after school, depending on what day it was, we would always go trick-or-treating around our neighborhood, because I lived in a neighborhood where it was mainly, like, older people, so they always gave so much candy away to the kids. Probably because, we invited them to their grandkids or something. I'm not sure why, but maybe they just wanted to piss off the parents. I'm not sure. But I don't know if you guys remember, but Coastal Oaks Church used to do a pumpkin patch way back in the day. And we would always go to that afterwards, because I used to go to the school there. And we would spend the rest of the evening there at the pumpkin patch just playing the games and enjoying the food and the music and the rides and everything. And I always loved that. And I hated when they canceled that. I was so mad. That was my favorite thing to do. And I hated that they got rid of it. And then there's one other time that I remember the Fulton Mansion used to do, like, haunted house tours, kind of.
Yeah.
They had themed things. I did a couple of those because I knew some people that worked there, and there was like, hey, do you want to come and, work it and whatever. And so there was one year where they did Alice in Wonderland themed, and I was one of the singing flowers. I hated that costume so much because the flower was made out of wood and it was so heavy. And then they did like a really creepy makeup with it. It did not look like it was a flower, but anyway. And then the next year they did like a zombie contagion haunted house one. And I remember I liked it a lot because I was the smallest one out of everybody. So they put me in the trash can to jump out and scare everybody. Of course, I had to have someone help me get into the trash can, but I digress. I loved doing that. And I'm hoping to do something like that here in my town that I live in now. They're supposed to be doing something here, so I hope to be a part of that as well. I always loved signing up for the community stuff where you get to dress up and scare the locals, so.
That's some. I remember Fulton Mansion. I always wanted to go, but I never could. I went to one thing. It was close, not to the Fulton Mansion, but it was close to like a lighthouse in Rockport at the time. It was close to that old HEB. There was something going on there when I was a kid. I went there. Then there was one all the way close to Fulton that was really cool. They had like a parade thing go around and a bunch of cool stuff there. I never actually got to go to a haunted house. I still haven't been to one. I've always wanted to go to one because I'm someone that doesn't scare easily, as y'all have seen this month. Go watch my videos if you haven't already, but you'll see in those that a lot of times I'm just laughing and having a good time.
Louisiana is known for having the best haunted houses because the state itself is very heavy in, like, the voodoo type stuff and everything, and hauntings and all kinds of like haunted tours and stuff they could do all the time. So Halloween is their shit. So I think that's probably a good location to go to if you want like a legit haunted house. I mean, I was a performer. I really enjoyed it. And my sister, when we did the Alice in Wonderland, she was the one that played the Jabberwocky. She loved torturing the little kids and scaring the crap out of them, because you couldn't see her behind like this black curtain, but she would reach out and try to grab the kids, and I would just hear so many blood curdling screams. I'm like, oh yeah, she's enjoying herself. She loves to torture the children. So
did y'all see that? Did y'all hear what she just? She just flexed like I was a performer.
I was in my element, okay? I even though the bar I had so much fun.
Dave, what are some of your favorite memories of Halloween?
Well, I think the most, it wasn't when I was a kid, but it was like right when I graduated high school. I would hang out with a bunch of my friends, and I was coming home from work. This was probably like, I don't know, 7 or like 8 o'clock at night. And I cut through the graveyard, and well, it was a homeless person that was laying there by a grave, but they were just wrapped up in a sleeping bag, and you know, it being Halloween, it kind of gave me the chills. So I got one of my friends who was he was taking photo class at college, so we decided to go there and, you know, check out the graveyard, and then after that we walked maybe like 5 miles to the next town where there's this famous haunted church, where it's actually, there's some history to it, where back in like in the 1800s there was a like a mass murder there where they just buried the bodies. And then there was a serial rapist that also would shove the bodies with rocks. So yeah, it's one of those places. And when we got there, you could hear like the animals, like the coyotes, they were acting funny. You could hear like the leaves moving, even though there was nothing there. And the church itself was boarded up, but you could see like imprints on the windows. And then, of course, we saw people, you're not allowed there at night, and we saw neighbors on the porch, so we went further into the woods and kind of got scared out of there with the coyotes coming towards us.
Talking about rocks being shoved up people's asses, this is a family show!
Since when has it ever been a family show?
You know, Disney's gonna acquire and set stuff up next week. Yeah, we're gonna start diversifying. Be prepared. So I identify as apricots.
We're going from the TV-14 era to the TV-PG era.
What is some of your favorite memories of Halloween?
Okay, so this one's sort of at my expense a little bit. I was a very skittish kid. I come from a family with a very, very strange sense of humor. So every year, my sister and I would go over to my great aunt's to get ready, you know, to get our costumes on. We would go with my mom's cousin, and then we would go out into the community, actually where their old house was, because they had moved. So they have this nice little sunroom, we can call it. In that sunroom was a bathroom. And me, I was like, okay, I'm going to use the sunroom to get ready, right? I go, I start getting ready. I have to use the bathroom, right? I open the toilet seat, and my other great aunt had put this little popper thing. It was like a little red monster, and I open the lid, it pops out, it doesn't like leave the toilet, but it's like sealed under the toilet seat, and I go shooting out screaming with my chonies around my ankles, screaming bloody murder out of the sunroof. And they just burst out laughing.
Oh man, she sounds like my kind of woman. I love pranks like that. I would have paid to do that.
I was traumatized.
Just the mental image of you screaming and running out of
there. I was probably like 5, 6, 7 years old at this point.
Oh man.
I remember one Halloween I was Buzz Lightyear. I remember one Halloween I was Blue from Blue's Clues. Another Halloween I was Anakin from Star Wars. Young Anakin from Phantom Menace. Another couple of years I was a couple of different Power Rangers. I was a ninja. Harry Potter. Some interesting stuff happens around Halloween. I'll just say that.
Some of my favorite memories, some of which were cruel memories. Let's go down and then we'll make our way up. Probably a cruel memory, you mentioned Harry Potter earlier. There was this thing going on at a library in Rockport. And at the time, I was dating Jessica. And we went there and we were supposed to watch this movie called Dark Shadows with Johnny Depp. And at the time... See, at the time, because I liked the classic stuff and I liked stuff that was actually scary, I'd never heard of this, so I thought it was going to be something stupid. But I was her boyfriend, so I was just like, all right, let's watch this scary movie. It was good. It's not something I watch now, but it's something every now and again when it's on, I'm like, oh, yeah, that's cool. But we watched that, and there was a bunch of cool stuff. You know, pumpkin cookies, which have always been some of my favorite things to eat. They only have them at H-E-B. They don't have them up here. Bunch of people were, we just laid on the floor and watched the movie. And then there was this contest. And I don't win shit. You think I'm a bad gamer? I never put my name in a raffle. I don't win. And there was this contest type of deal drawing. And whoever won... got all 7 books of Harry Potter hardback. I mean, all of them. Brand new. And I actually fucking won. I kept asking, is there a mistake? There's got to be a mistake. I don't win. And I remember when I got in the car, my mom, who was already very unhappy about having to pick me up, because God forbid she... take care of her son, but she was like, did you steal those? Because I'm coming out of the library with 7 new books. I'm like, no, I won. She made a big old fit and embarrassed me, but I still have those books. I still have all of them right up there. That was really cool because I don't normally win stuff. I was like, I won the entire collection, brand new. That was something. Some of the other memories happened when I was a lot older. This is when I was already an adult, just a few years ago. I had this buddy of mine, Josh, who was very impressionable. And I used to fuck with that dude so much. It was a Halloween back in 2016, 2015. And I used to have my buddies come over all the time. Steven, Drake, Ian, Josh, and sometimes Dino. And sometimes they'd sleep. There was, we had a love seat, we had a bed, then we had this long-ass couch. Josh wanted to sleep on the bed. He didn't want to be near any of us because we'd always fuck with him in some way. That's just how it works. I remember shortly before this, he'd come over to my house. Me, him, and Drake watched Paranormal Activity, the first one, and it was uncut, so it's the one where at the end you actually see the girl slit her throat. And when he's watching it, by the end of it, when it's getting to that ending, he stood up out of his chair and he's tapping his feet really fast like this, acting like, oh my god, oh my god, and then he ran out. The thing that sucked about this at the time was I was sleeping upstairs on the couch. Drake was going home with Josh. Because of how late it was, his dad would have come pick him up. So Drake leaves. Josh is scared. Josh was supposed to sleep downstairs by himself. He ends up coming upstairs and crying, begging to sleep right beside me on the floor. And I'm like, so I'm sitting there and he won't shut up. So I turn on the TV and I'm watching American Horror Story. He's like, really? Are you going to watch that right now? I'm like, why not? He's like, because of what we just watched. I'm like, that shit don't bother me. This shit is enjoyable to me. And unless you shut up, I'm going to put on the sequel. So eventually he did. But then we get a few weeks later, and I wanted to fuck with him. I don't remember what kind of story I told, but I was talking about some stuff that was happening near the boat barns, and because we were right close to a canal, and everyone went to sleep. And I remember I snuck out, and I was clawing against the side, making him hear stuff. And then I sneaked back in the house. He kept hearing that. It was right outside where he was sleeping. Finally, what happens is I end up going outside, and he's like, no, don't do it, don't do it. I remember thinking, like, at least he cares about me for now. And I got some ketchup, and I acted like I got stabbed and was dying in the driveway. I was just like, oh my God. And the other three went along with it, and Josh was just like, I don't know if he was there anymore at that point. But after that, it got a lot worse, because once we moved past that, he was kind of pissed that I was kidding and whatnot. And we had this house three streets over. I think I passed the statute of limitations, so I shouldn't get in trouble for what I'm about to say. Maybe I'll put some of the video in the background, just in case the cops need some evidence. this place wasn't owned yet. It was being built, and there was like three stories. I would come here and I'd listen to music. I would escape. This was a very different time. I hated everything. So sometimes they'd come with me, sometimes they wouldn't. And we'd come and we'd do all sorts of stuff. We'd there was this big trash can, and we'd go to the third story and we'd take some wood and we'd chuck it out. Pepsi?
You got a big ass fucking.
I really started this whole shit, but.
Big ass piece of wood. Alright, let's go. 3, 2.
Go.
1. Go. There you go.
Oh shit.
Oh shit. Sorry for the shitty recording.
Hey, that's how you do when you a Pepsi, yo. And then make a loud bang and we'd run inside. We were doing this at 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning. Josh never came. Not at first. It was just me, Steven, and Drake. So, there you go. Now you cops have the information you need. I did a lot of stupid stuff. I wrote my name, Pepsi, in the drywall when it was just, you know, I did a lot of shit. One of the stupid things I did, you know what? I'm not going to tell that story. We'll tell that story when we have an illegal podcast. But anyway, so I ended up making Josh follow me there and set up a whole bunch of spooky shit with Steven and Drake. And whenever I got the chance, because I was acting like something was happening to me, there was this little loft and stuff. I jumped down there. I kept sneaking around making sounds. And then I hauled ass. You ever seen a fat guy run at 2 o'clock in the morning? I hauled ass! Went all the way
only
around.
Only to Taco Bell, Pepsi. Only to Taco Bell.
Hey, that's how you do when you a Pepsi, yo. And I got back.
That's not right.
Josh didn't come back to the house for about 2.5-3 hours. He was still looking for me. Finally, he comes back, and I'm just like, oh, what happened? Me and Ian, because Ian came with me. He was like, what? We've been here the whole time. What's going on? Josh didn't come over for about a month after that. He was pissed. But it didn't help that when we were walking there, Ian was talking about feeling a dark energy over in the brush and this shit. And I'm just sitting there, and I'm like, Come at me, bro. I'm saved by the brother of Christ. I'm saved by Christ. I can't be touched. I say all this shit. Josh is like, shut up, shut up, shut up. That was a fond memory. I've got a lot of good ones. But fucking with people was always something I was good at. So I loved doing that more than anything else. Sweets without the spooky. So,
you know, that kind of reminds me. Like I said, I'm not huge into horror movies. But one time I had my buddy over here at my grandparents' place. He had the bright idea of saying, okay, we're going to watch both the Ring movies. Both, you know, the Ring 1 and the Ring 2.
You're scared of Lord of the Rings?
No, the Ring. Not Lord of the Rings. The Ring. Get it? Right.
Sorry, I couldn't help it.
So, okay. So, we watched the first one. Then we decide, okay, we're going to order a pizza. We order the pizza. Hang up the phone. Him being the sneaky son of a gun that he is, he ended up calling and just being like, 7 days. Oh my gosh, we were just clowning on each other with that. Push comes to shove, a couple of months later, we're supposed to go to see this horror movie, right? The Possession of Hannah Grace. That movie was so unbelievably bad. We were, like, the only two in the theater, to put it in perspective. And instead of being freaked out, we were just clowning on this movie the whole time. There was this little redheaded dude in there, reminded us of our buddy Damon, and we were like, no, Damon, go the other way, don't go through there, Damon. And we were just clowning on this movie to this day. To this day, I will look upon that event with fondness. But that day, I laughed, and I laughed. And I laughed. There's just no words to describe the humor that we had in about that almost hour and a half that movie ran.
Look, I don't know what anyone to get the wrong idea. Like, we've talked about costumes, we've talked about favorite memories, but honestly, I hate Halloween, and there's no way you can prove that any part of me likes Halloween. So. What?
Oh, that's cute. I like that.
Yeah, I know. Your Halloween is showing.
I'm not drinking anything, I promise.
Are you drinking True Blood?
Actually, I dropped out candy because the next part of what we're going to talk about is our favorite candies. So, I will go first, I guess, this time, and say that my favorite candy when I was younger to get for Halloween, this is just for Halloween, not in general. If you want to say in general, you can say afterwards. Like, in general, if I only could have one candy for the rest of my life, a Bueno would do me right. I'd be happy with that.
I was just introduced to those like a year ago.
Those are amazing. But,
oh, yes.
Growing up, the ones I always wanted was a Reese's.
My boy.
And a Kit Kat.
Oh, there you go.
I always wanted Reese's. And those were my go-to. Those still are like my second favorite candy, although I feel like now it's become Bueno, Kit Kat, then Reese's.
Being from where I'm at, you know, anything for the most part Hershey's, that was my jam. That was my jam. Now, there was some stuff from the competition, which when I'd go through Chocolate World down there in Hershey, we wouldn't even be able to say the word Mars. You know, the makers of M&M's and all the other crazy candy. But I liked my gobstoppers. I liked my nerds. Nerds rope. Sweet tarts. You know, all that type of stuff. Skittles. Oh, where it was at for me, what my jam was, peanut butter cups all the way. To the point. When I was going through elementary school, there was actually a couple. The wife taught second grade, the husband taught fourth grade. On my birthday, when I was in second grade, Mr. Nixdorf had some of his fourth graders come in and sing happy birthday to me and play it on kazoos and give me peanut butter cups for my birthday. I was the only one that got that kind of treat. Oh my gosh, so many crazy candy-related stories and candy-related occurrences happened in my life. You'd almost think that I was positioned to be the next Willy Wonka.
I mean, even today, I still feel like I'm with you as far as Reese's goes. Like, specifically, like Reese's Pieces. But anything Reese's or M&M's.
M&M's are
boring. Musketeers.
I mean, if it's an M&M's with peanuts or M&M with pretzel, I discovered that about 5 or 6 years ago. M&M's with pretzels in them, crazy. But just plain M&M's, it's just kind of like, I don't care for them. But,
oh, I hear you.
I do love Reese's Pieces. All right, well, what about you, yes. Sarah? What was your favorite as a child, and what's your favorite now?
I don't think I remember really having a favorite type of candy. I was the type of kid that liked just about... I think the only kind that I really didn't like was, like, the sour. The really extreme sour, like the Warheads and stuff. I really didn't like those too much. But there was probably never really any type of piece of chocolate or a gummy that I didn't like. If I have to narrow it down to a favorite as a kid, I'd have to probably say Kit Kats. I remember at the private school that I was going to at the time, for whoever's birthday it was, they would give them their own little like birthday bucket full of like their favorite treats, their favorite salty snacks, their favorite, you know, hobbies, things like that. They make you fill out like a questionnaire and stuff. And I remember that I think it was the year that I turned 13. They gave me the biggest bag of Kit Kats that I had ever seen. And it was a mix of, like, not just the regular, but the white chocolate and the dark chocolate. That bag lasted me the entire year. Like, I could, even by the end of the year, I still had some left. And I remember my family would sneak into my room and take some of my Kit Kats and be like, "You don't mind, right?" I'm like, "Well, yeah, I mean, I'm not going to eat all of them by myself." But, I used to not like Reese's that much either. I would eat them, but they weren't something I would always seek out, really. If they were there, then I would enjoy them. But I didn't start really liking Reese's until I was an adult. And then for some reason, I don't know what happened, my palate just changed or something. I don't know, but I just craved them so much. And
Every 7 years, your taste buds change.
That's probably it, yeah.
I mean, I love it, so...
I'm still the same, I think, now. I mean, I always was the type of person that whenever Halloween comes around, if I have a couple pieces of candy, I have to have something that's chocolate and then something that's, like, fruity or gummy, like a sucker or, like, a Swedish fish or a Starburst or something or Skittles. I like having the variety, having, like, one of each. But, yeah, there's really no candy that I don't really enjoy.
Well, right now... We're gonna have a little debate, and in order to do that, I have to get rid of my background, so enjoy seeing my room and seeing Linda, if y'all care. Room's a little bit of a mess, I apologize. But at least this way, when I hold something up, it'll stay up. Maybe I can actually even wear my bunny ears for this part.
There you go, so cute.
Yay.
They're not completely in frame, but...
Yeah. So, we have to come down to the three best candies of all time. So, some of these you might remember from childhood. You're going to say yay or nay. You can talk about it for a little bit, but at the end of the day, we've got to choose what the best are. So, who remembers These little shits. Dots.
Those are my sister's favorite. She loved those. We'd always trade, and I'd always give her my dots, and she'd give me something else. Those are her favorite.
I like them. They're okay. I'm so caught up in your teeth and stuff.
You had braces, you could not eat those. Uh-uh.
Oh, yeah.
They would end at all colors of the rainbow stuck in your braces.
So
I like them. I wouldn't say they're in my top 10, though.
Not in your top 10. What about you guys?
I agree. I mean, they're good when they're there, but like just kind of like with the Reese's before, it's not something I would actively seek out.
All right. No on them. So here's a really good one that my grandmother loved, and I really do enjoy. A Baby Ruth.
Oh, yeah, I
used to love them.
For those that don't know, like they're dry roasted peanuts, rich caramel, and smooth nougat. These are really good.
They are good. I used to not really like them that much as a kid, but I mean, like I said, if they were there.
There's a version of Reese's that's like nutritious, it's not nutritious, but Nutterous or whatever. It's just like a Babe Ruth. It's, you know, it's really, really good. I wish I could remember what it's called. So, does anyone think this is in the top 10?
If it is, it's probably on the lower side of the top 10, but yeah.
I like them more than Dots, but I'm still it's not something that I would ever look for.
Right. Yeah, I agree.
It still needs to manage to beat out a Three Musketeers in my book, which is a little hard.
So, the next one, Three Musketeers.
There you go.
Top 10 for you guys?
I would definitely say that's top 10.
I like how silky.
Might even be one.
I like the taste, and then I like how silky the inside is. I really like
it. I like Babe Ruth more. But.
It's okay. We value your opinion.
Since it's three versus one, I will put it in the Halloween cup. Now, here comes, like, to me, one of the worst things for Halloween. I didn't even know they give these out, but Twizzlers.
No.
Only if they were the peel ones, then yes.
Those are good.
Regular ones, I don't like those.
I definitely do not like the licorice.
I think that's what they're pretty much.
I think they are like the same, like brand. But.
I already know this is gonna be in the top 10. It's just a formality. Snickers.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, they're definitely in the top 10.
Love Snickers,
especially the ice cream ones.
I was honestly a huge fan of Snickers, honestly.
What about that?
If you put me in a candy aisle, 9 times out of 10, I will still go for a Reese's-related product over a Snickers.
We understand. If you could, you'd rub yourself all over with Reese's. I would, too. You got it.
Three versus one,
it goes in the pumpkin. Let's go ahead and get this out of the way, because I'm pretty sure Forrest is all hot and bothered anyway. Reese's, top 10, yes or no?
Absolutely. I kind of go back and forth with Reese's and Musketeers.
Now, here's one that I love, because I always wanted to get Kit Kats and Reese's, and I didn't realize how much I loved Babe Ruth till later, but I always thought these were good, too. Crunch.
Oh, I love Crunch.
Oh, yeah, I forgot all about that. But yeah, I do. That's definitely top 10.
I like that.
I was never really a big fan, and still to this day, I'm not a huge fan of Crunch.
All right, we'll see you later. Thank you for joining
us. It was nice knowing you. What type of tree are you, Forrest?
Remember, you need to come in train your replacement.
Yes, and make sure they get real choice.
Give them your badge.
All right, well, since we know where Forrest stands, do you three agree this is the top 10 best?
Yes.
Definitely.
All right. It's okay to be wrong, Forrest. Here's one that also gets really in your teeth, but my dad loves, and there's multiple variations of this, and that's kind of what I'm going to get out real quick.
Oh, boy, you better not lay a finger on my Butterfinger.
Dude, okay. I don't even have a Butterfinger in here.
Probably because it slipped.
I like them, but they changed their recipe, and I don't really like the way that they changed it.
I like the old one.
I don't like the new recipe.
So, Tootsie,
Oh, I love Tootsie Rolls so much. I hate the vanilla ones, though. I cannot stand that flavor. I like every other flavor.
I appreciate that there is a vanilla because there's someone out there that likes it, but I didn't care for it.
It's not me. It's not me. I like the fruity ones, too. I just don't like the vanilla ones. That's the only one I can't stand.
Which one of these did you like the best?
For me?
Are they all just the same to you?
I liked the big ones the most, but when I was in, like, when I had braces and stuff, I liked the skinny ones the best, because then they wouldn't break my brackets.
Yeah.
I'd always have the smaller ones.
The smaller ones, yeah. I don't think I ever knew about these big-ass ones till.
Oh, they've been around for a long time.
So,
oh, yeah.
Top 10 greatest of all time, yes or no?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Here's one that I've always loved. And it doesn't matter who it's by. I've always loved gummy worms.
Oh yeah, any type of gummy, whether it's like the sour crawly ones, or gummy bears, or gummy worms.
So would we say they're top 10 greatest of all time?
I think so.
Really? Yeah, I think so. I like gummies.
I'm gonna show this on the screen, and then I'm just gonna put it in the cup. Because I already know it's the top 10 greatest of all time.
Absolutely.
So here's where it gets interesting. Buttercream.
Old recipe, yes. New recipe, no.
Forrest?
I agree.
Yep.
Alright, so I guess it's not the greatest anymore.
It used to be.
Once upon a time. You know what I've started to love? And they used to have. I used to think it was just like, oh, it's whatever, but I really like it. Twix.
Twix are good. Twix are really good.
They are good. Although they're more like technically cookies.
That's why I like them. They're crunchy, they're creamy. I mean.
Here's a debate for the ages: right Twix or left Twix?
I'm left-handed. Both? I'll say left. Both. That's a good answer. Yes.
I remember that whole marketing scheme a couple of years
ago. They're still doing that.
And I'm just like, a Twix is a Twix.
You can buy like the singles, then it has like
I got two rights.
Left or right.
Let's see. This one's right as well. So, is this top 10? Because honestly, I feel like it is now.
It is.
Uh-huh. Let's talk about a galaxy. A Milky Way.
Ooh, definitely.
Really?
I always enjoyed Milky Ways, bro.
I think they're okay. But I don't think they're the top best.
I don't think so. I think if I had to choose between that or a Snickers, I'd pick a Snickers.
It's not that absolutely. We hate you for it, it's just that you're wrong. Okay?
Yeah, you suck. We don't hate you, but you suck.
So wait,
go away.
So wait, just so I can make sure, is Forrest the only one that thinks this is in the top 10?
I think so.
Okay. Forrest, you can hang your shirt up on the way out, okay?
Yep, give me your badge. Gonna give it to the next person.
I know how Sarah's going to feel about this next one. Fruit juice.
Yeah, I like the fruity ones.
I don't think it's the best of all time, but it is cool. You know, it doesn't have to be the best, but... Do you guys think
what
it's
is
the
it?
Top 10?
Fruit
it's
juice?
It's the Tootsie Rolls, but the fruity flavors.
Oh, yeah, I know what you're talking about. They are good.
Never really had them, honestly.
Alright, so here's what we have in the top 10 that we have to break down into three. Tootsie Rolls. Crunch. Reese's. Gummy Bears. Three Musketeers. Can't believe that shit got out of there. Twix, Snickers, and
what'd you call me?
I have to figure out what the best is first, and then put it up against everything else. So, Three Musketeers versus a Reese's.
Reese's.
Okay.
Reese's.
All right, hold up. Three Musketeers versus a Tootsie Roll.
Three Musketeers.
Really?
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
So that's an interesting thing there. Three Musketeers versus the Snickers.
Three Musketeers.
Sarah?
I said Snickers.
Alright, that's 2v1. Okay, we'll have to come back to that one. Three Musketeers versus a Crunch.
Three Musketeers.
I'd pick Crunch.
Yes.
Okay. What is wrong with you?
She's just right. Leave her alone.
Sorry.
Right.
Where's the delete button?
All right. Right or left Twix versus the Three Musketeers.
It depends what side of the Twix it is.
I'd say Twix.
Yeah, I agree.
Really?
Twix, I don't know.
Yes. Okay, so like Twix better than, because that's three on that one. Okay. Kit Kat versus Musketeers.
Kit Kat.
Yeah. Reese's versus Three Musketeers. We might already
play Reese's.
Okay. I think we did that one, but yeah.
So that's like four that have already done it. Gummy Bears versus Three Musketeers.
Gummy Bears.
Yeah, Gummy Bears.
Yeah.
All right, that is over four candies that we have chosen over Three Musketeers. So if you're so I'm going to go ahead and throw this out because that's four that are 100% better than this in y'all's eyes. So
Pepsi, hold on, Pepsi, didn't you say you didn't like Three Musketeers?
Yes, I don't.
So now here's your challenge. Since it's voted out, you gotta eat it.
I can't eat any chocolate. Why do you think I'm not? My original plan for recording this was after I did that reveal of this, was I was gonna start eating each one and talk about it throughout. I can't eat this. It's chocolate. I'm sick. I wish I could.
Yeah,
it's what Forrest, I wanted to fucking
have a heart.
Eat. Do you know how bad I want to eat this Forrest. Right now?
Bad. I don't know. I would have eaten it regardless if I was sick or not.
Yeah, I don't know why I would do.
It's dairy, though. It's dairy.
That's not... It's
chocolate. It's not good for
you.
Well, fine, I'll eat it.
When do you do anything that's good for you?
What does that have to do with anything?
He's sick, and you want to make him eat something he doesn't like that's going to make him sicker.
Apparently.
That's so heartless, Forrest.
I didn't know they were chewy.
Have you never actually had one before?
I have. I think they're okay. They're just not the best. I would never buy one. I would trade two.
Well, that's the thing about Halloween. You don't have to buy your candy. They give
it
to you.
All right. So that's out. Let's get difficult.
What? So be you?
Versus Reese's.
Reese's. Reese's.
Absolutely.
Reese's.
I say Kit Kat. At least what nowadays. The reason is because before I got sick, I had one of these. Something has changed, at least in these cups. But Reese's as a whole, it's great. But if I had to choose between one of these and this all day.
Reese's. I agree. I like Reese's too, but I would still rather have a Kit Kat.
All right. So that's 2v1. So
break me one off one of those.
Let's go Kit. Twix versus Reese's.
Reese's.
Reese's, okay. Gummy Bears versus Reese's.
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 Okay. Crunch versus Reese's.
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 Snickers versus Reese's.
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 Tootsie Roll versus Reese's.
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 Reese's is crowned at number one so far. There we go. Twix versus Kit Kat.
I'd rather
have
Kit Kat.
Yeah. Okay. So Kit Kat so far winning. Let's do Twix versus Gummy Bears.
Twix.
I would choose
Gummy Bears.
Really?
Yeah.
I agree with Forrest.
So how many is that?
Oh my. That's two and two.
It's split. It's two and two.
Okay. Twix versus Crunch.
Twix.
Okay. Yeah.
Twix versus Tootsie.
Twix.
And Snickers versus Twix.
Twix.
Okay. So far, Twix is an oddball. Let's get out the one that I know is going to probably lose this. Kit Kat versus Gummy Bear.
Kit Kat.
All right. Kit Kat versus Crunch.
Gummy Bear.
Wait, what?
Kit Kat versus Crunch. Boy, oh, you said gummy.
So, alright. I'll put that to the side. Gummy Bear versus Snickers.
Gummy Bears.
Gummy Bears.
Yeah, Gummy Bears.
What have you done to my boy? Gummy bear versus Tootsie Roll?
Gummy bear.
Gummy bear.
Fuck, how the hell is gummy bear a possibility? Okay, so now we have three that
everyone's unsure. That's the only fruit-laden candy you have there. You don't have Skittles or anything
else. Well, there's a bunch of the other ones. They just didn't make it out of the top one.
You don't have Airheads.
Well, you know, next time you can plan the budget, okay?
Skittles or gummy bears that take Skittles.
Twix versus Snickers.
Twix.
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 Alright. Twix versus
Tootsie. Twix.
Twix.
Alright. Twix versus Crunch.
Twix.
Alright. So, that puts that there. Snickers versus Crunch.
Snickers.
I'd rather have Crunch.
Force?
Snickers.
Okay. Crunch versus Tootsie.
Let's see.
Crunch.
Crunch.
Okay. Tootsie is out of it. It's been set enough. So what we have left is five. So I'm going to mix them up, and this is going to be the lightning round. Whatever I grab goes against the other, and you just got to decide. Kit Kat or Gummy Bear if you're on an island?
Kit Kat.
Kit Kat? For Dave? Sarah?
Kit Kat.
So Kit Kat, correct?
Yeah,
gummy bears.
Kit Kat for me.
All right, so gummy bears is out. All right, now we've got Kit Kat and Snickers.
Kit Kat.
Kit Kat.
All right, Snickers is out. I'm very surprised at that. So we're in our last ones. So Kit Kat versus Crunch.
Kit Kat.
Kit Kat.
Kit Kat versus Kit Kat. Twix.
Twix.
I'd rather have Kit Kat.
Yeah, me too.
All right. Kit Kat is the second best candy. Twix versus Crunch.
Twix.
Twix.
Twix. Okay. So, you heard it here on our podcast. If we were going out trick-or-treating, we would love to have a Reese's, Twix, and Kit Kats. And I don't think that's too bad, to be honest. All right. So that's it for our candy debate. So how many of you actually did the assignment and got a spooky story?
Does it count if I got a book?
I cheated.
That counts.
I wrote down a dream.
Let's go with Dave's dream and see how scary it is.
There was a night back yonder where I dreamt of a dark stormy night. On this dark night, there were asteroids falling like a war from the sky. The day after was still dark, so dark not only was the sun gone from the sky, but the moon was no more. On that very day, zombie-type aliens took over most of the population. I fought back, though only could they be destroyed by the back using stealth. Kept them back using my martial arts training for a time. I hid and found a place to hide. Figured that was it. So I hid and slept. Woke up to a voice from above. God? Telling me to gather the people and bring them to a ladder that dropped from the sky and climb it all the way above the clouds. And that's... Then I woke up.
So an apocalypse...
Kind
of like, I'd read a book about that. People dream up some really weird shit.
Yeah, I know.
I mean, Sarah! That's how Harry Potter was made.
Really?
Yeah, it was a dream.
Wow, that's cool. I did not know that. That's
right?
So cool. So I'm reading from the nostalgic Scary Stories to Tell in the Dark. I'm pretty sure we all had told these to our friends when we were kids. So, also leave a comment which one of these are your favorites down below.
Yes.
Alrighty.
And mine was the Viper.
There you go. The Thing. Ed Martin and Sam Miller were good friends. They spent a lot of time together. On this particular night, they were sitting on a fence near the post office, talking about one thing and another. There was a field of turnips across the road. Suddenly, they saw something crawl out of the field and stand up. It looked like a man, but in the dark it was hard to tell for sure. And it was gone. But soon, it appeared again. It walked halfway across the road, then it turned around and went back into the field. Then it came out a third time and started toward them. By now, Ted and Sam were scared, and they started running. But when they finally stopped, they decided they were being foolish. They weren't sure what had scared them. So they decided to go back and get a better look. Pretty soon they saw it, for it was coming to meet them. It was wearing black pants, a white shirt, and black suspenders. Sam said, "I'm going to try to touch it. Then we'll know if it's real." He walked up to it and peered into its face. It had bright, penetrating eyes sunk deep in its head. It looked like a skeleton. Ted took one look and screamed, and again he and Sam ran, but this time the skeleton followed them. When they got to Ted's house, they stood in the doorway and watched it. It stayed out in the road for a while, then it disappeared. A year later, Ted got sick and died. Toward the end, Sam sat up with him every night. The night Ted died, Sam said he looked just like the skeleton.
I don't know.
I feel like a lot of these stories are scarier when we're kids.
Probably. Forrest, you're next. Scare us.
Okay. This one is called The World's Best School Psychologist. When I was 12, I came to the conclusion that everyone in the world, including my own family, was against me. I was never a problem child, but my parents sure treated me like one. For example, I used to need to be home by 5 p.m. every day. This clearly restricted my amount of playtime outdoors. I wasn't allowed to have friends over to play at the house, nor was I allowed to go over to anyone else's. I had to finish homework directly after I came home from school, no matter how long it took. My parents refused to buy me video games and forced me to read books and then write a book report on them to prove I actually read it. Now, even though those rules listed above were quite frustrating to me as a child, they aren't what upset me most. What really hurt me was the lack of compassion on behalf of my parents. My mother was a bitter woman who always made me feel guilty about accidents or mistakes I've made. My father only knew one emotion, frustration. The only time he spoke to me was when he screamed at me for receiving poor test scores or beat me for misbehaving. But enough about them. Let's talk about my school psychologist. For his own privacy, we'll call him Dr. Tanner. Like most junior high schools, a psychologist is always available on campus during school hours to assist any students in need of counseling, whether it is emotional, academic, social, behavioral, or etc. To be honest, I have never seen any students talking with Dr. Tanner. Every day, I would walk past his office on my way to the cafeteria and peek through his door's little window. He would always be alone in there, working on some paperwork. I guess that most kids were too afraid to speak about their problems to an adult, who was practically a stranger. For this reason, it took me 3 weeks to muster enough courage to go into his office. March 2nd, 1993 was the day I decided to voice my troubles to Dr. Tanner. During lunch break, I stood in front of his office door and knocked. Through the window, I could see him raise his head, smile, and motion for me to come in. I did. He greeted me by introducing himself and asking for my name. Dr. Tanner was a very soft-spoken man. He seemed to radiate kindness. In less than 30 minutes, I rambled to Dr. Tanner about how mean my parents were to me and how they didn't care about me at all. After a while, my voice began to quiver, and I stopped speaking. The psychologist listened patiently to my whole spiel, arms folded and head nodding. I half expected him to begin talking about how everything I had just said was untrue and that my parents loved me very dearly and blah, 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 but he didn't. Dr. Tanner leaned towards me with a grin on his face and said, "You know, I'm the best school psychologist in the world." I promise we will fix this. I rolled my eyes. Okay, but how? I asked. I have my ways, he replied. I'm a man of my word. I promise that within just 1 month, the relationship between you and your parents will change for the better. Forever. After a brief pause, he continued. Although, I do need you to make me a promise. You have to promise me that you'll come back to my office after school tomorrow, and that you won't tell anyone that we had this conversation today. It'll be our little secret. I promise. The following day, I returned to Dr. Tanner after school. It was around 4 o'clock p.m. when I entered his office. After a warm welcome, he asked me to have a seat in front of his desk once again. Upon sitting down, I watched Dr. Tanner close the blinds of the door's tiny window. There, he smiled. Now we have all the privacy we need. He began to talk about my likes and interests, my favorite subjects in school, my least favorite teachers, and things of the like. About an hour into the conversation, Dr. Tanner offered me a soft drink. I gladly took the offer, considering my parents never allowed me to drink soda. Dr. Tanner reached over to his mini fridge and fidgeted around before setting down two open cans of soda on the desk. Afterwards, we continued to talk about what was going on in my life, but it wasn't long before I passed out from whatever drugs Dr. Tanner had placed in my drink. It took me a minute or so to adjust my blurred vision upon waking. And when I did, I had no idea what to think. I was handcuffed to a bed, and my mouth was sealed with duct tape. I immediately began to panic, squirming and tugging at the cuffs, but gave up soon after. My eyes widened in disbelief after looking around the room. There were posters of superheroes pinned up along the walls and photographs of famous athletes on shelves. In the middle of the room was an old television and Super Nintendo, various video game cartridges stacked alongside it. I didn't know what to think. Here I am in a room filled with items most kids would die to play with. I would have probably cried from joy hadn't I been handcuffed to a bed frame. My stomach sank once again as the door opened and Dr. Tanner walked inside. He sat down on the edge of the bed. Now listen, he said. Remember that I'm here to help you, and I would never hurt you, okay? Dr. Tanner gently removed the tape from my mouth and then the cuffs from my hands. My first instinct was to begin crying, but something about Dr. Tanner made me feel safe. He smiled at me. You're going to be staying here for a while, he continued. During this time, you're allowed to play with any toys in this room while I'm here at home. But when I leave the house, I'll need to cuff one of your hands back to the bed. You can still watch the television, but I want you to only watch the news channels when I'm away. I sat in silence, still trying to process the information he had given me. So, Dr. Tanner yipped, slapping me on the knee. You go ahead and knock yourself out. I'll be back when it's time for dinner. He got up from the bed, walked across the room, and clicked the TV's power button before locking the door behind him. Several more minutes passed before I realized that Dr. Tanner wasn't joking. All that was left for me to do was boot up the Nintendo and play Mario until nightfall. At about 7 p.m., Dr. Tanner returned to the room carrying two plates of mashed potatoes and chicken strips. I finally gathered up the courage to ask him how long I'd be staying in this room. Well, about a month, he replied. Give or take a few weeks. I just have some work I need to do. The following morning, I awoke to Dr. Tanner's hand patting my head. Hey, bud, you don't have to wake up right now if you don't want, but I am going to need to put this back on, he whispered, clamping the cold steel cuff onto my wrist. I gazed up at him. He was wearing a collared shirt and slacks. The coat draped over his shoulder and a suitcase at his side. He looked just like how he always did when I saw him around school. Before leaving, he placed the TV's remote next to me and told me to turn it on and watch the news. The first thing I saw upon turning it on was a breaking news segment,
An important-looking police officer stood at a podium surrounded by people with microphones. I happened to begin viewing halfway through his speech. A statewide Amber Alert has been issued as of this morning. We have several investigators working towards identifying potential abductors, but as of right now, there is not much evidence. Faculty members state that a boy had been last seen around 4 or 5 in the evening. I began to feel nauseous as a photograph of me appeared on the screen. It was my yearbook picture from last year. Captions for the photograph displayed my name and age, my school, and my town. Above my picture were alternating titles. FBI begins search for child and kidnapping suspect unknown and potential runaway. Live footage continued, and two figures I soon recognized as my mom and dad stepped up to the podium. Both appeared to have reddened eyes. Tears streamed down my mother's face as she took a hold of a microphone. I'd never seen so much emotion come from my mother before as she wept on live television, stuttering on sentences such as, "Please return my baby back to me," and "I'm so sorry," and "Please come home to us." When my father took the microphone, I nearly expected his attitude to be stone cold, but he too had tears in his eyes. He pleaded to the world to bring his son home safely and lastly begged for my forgiveness. I know I haven't been the best father. But I do wish I had been now. Please bring my boy back. I turned the power off shortly after. My emotions were mixed, for I had never once seen my father cry. I felt miserable that my parents were being put through so much, but at the same time I felt relief. I now know how much my mom and dad love me. Nearly 4 weeks have passed and Dr. Tanner has been treating me with the utmost respect. He leaves me in the morning cuffed to the bed frame, but returns in the afternoon to eat lunch and dinner with me, talk and play games. I never would have guessed how good Dr. Tanner was at Monopoly and Scrabble. But one morning when Dr. Tanner woke me before heading off to work, I noticed a stern look on his face. I also realized that it was 3 hours earlier than when he usually wakes me. "You need to watch the news today. No exceptions. I want you to keep the television on all day and pay close attention to it," he stated grimly. I, of course, complied and watched him exit the room. About 2 hours later, a breaking news segment interrupted the toothpaste commercial I was watching. The title: Human Remnants Found. Two staunch-looking men in suits stood aside one another and began speaking. "We are displeased to bring up such unfortunate news this morning regarding our missing child case from earlier this month." One of the men bowed his head while the other speaking shuffled through some paperwork. "Remains of a body have been found in a garbage bag beneath a highway overpass. The body appears to be that of a child, although not much of it is left. The body has been decapitated, and much has been burnt to ash and bone." The screen shifted over to a helicopter view of the freeway. Dozens of police cars gathered near the bottom of a tall overpass. The man's voice could still be heard. "Within the bag, police found a junior high school identification card labeled as such." The screen showed the school ID card I always kept in my backpack. The plastic was sort of melted away, but my photograph and name were intact. After the two men dismissed themselves, the camera panned over to my parents. They were sitting among reporters. My mother's face held a painful grimace, and my father sulked, his head down at his knees. I shut the television off. Dr. Tanner returned home very late. He hurried into the room, unlocked my cuffs, and placed a bottle of fizzing water into my hand. He placed his hand onto my shoulders and smiled. "I made you a promise, didn't I?" I nodded, tears squeezing their way out of my eyes. "You need to make me a promise again," he whispered. "You told me that I needed to drink all the water in the bottle. It would help me sleep. And that from here on, I am never to tell anyone that I ever met him. I promise." I told you, I'm the world's best school I'm the best school psychologist in the world, didn't I? And she was right. I awoke later that night to find myself lying in the middle of a park, stars shining brightly across the night sky. I recognized the park. It wasn't too far from my school. Mile or so down the road, I saw my house. Lights were off inside, but I could make out my father sitting on the step leading to the front door. I hesitantly called out to him. He lifted his head slowly, but when he saw it was me, he sprang to his feet, ran towards me, arms open, yelling my name. My mother erupted from the house behind him. Dr. Tanner was right. Things have changed with my family and I. My parents smile more often and treat me lovingly. I could not ask for a more perfect ending. Every now and then, I see Dr. Tanner on campus, walking to and from his office. Rarely do we ever make eye contact, let alone speak to one another, but sometimes he'll shoot me a wink and a smile. I'll always keep my promise to him and pretend I never met, but there will always be one question forever floating in my mind. Who did Dr. Tanner decapitate?
Yeah, that's what I've been thinking the whole fucking time. Who the fuck did he kill?
Wait, is this a story from,
It's a creepypasta.
Oh, okay. That makes sense.
I love that.
That was good.
I'm not gonna lie.
You should check it out.
Boris, whenever you talked about the bottle, I thought the kid was gonna drink it, fall asleep, and then he was gonna be decapitated too. But then
yeah, I thought that. Back.
I was like, okay, and then this whole time,
honestly,
I'm like,
I didn't know what to expect. So this was my first time reading it too.
That was good.
That's crazy. My first thought was, oh wow, all it took was their kid to get kidnapped for them to be able to show affection. That's nice. Right.
My mom would have been like, hey, can you take
some silver lining?
All right, let's get started, you guys.
Just use the restroom, like I said, I had to. Oh, so.
Okay. Cool. Put on your jacket, look cool, play with your dimple, and shut up. So here we go.
This is not that kind of show, Pepsi.
All right, ready? Here's my scary story.
No, to everyone who's curious, Pepsi will have his OnlyFans up starting in the new year.
Yes, you get there. All right. Disney acquired the Star Wars rights. So guys, here's what time it is now. The final segment.
What's your favorite scary movie?
I love it.
Ghostface. Sarah, what besides Halloween Town is your favorite scary movie? Your go-to for Halloween?
If I have to pick something that's in the horror genre, I'd have to probably say The Conjuring. I love The Conjuring series. The third one was not as scary as the other two, but I still love the series.
Alright. Forrest, what is your favorite childhood scary movie that's, you know, and favorite scary movie now?
This one's a little bit of a hot take.
Ooh.
But as a kid, I loved You're the Great Pumpkin, Charlie Brown.
Alright.
Aw, that's cute!
I love that one. But if we're talking Disney Channel Halloween movies, I'd definitely say the Halloween Town movies or Phantom of the Megaplex.
Oh, I remember that one.
And then, to date, I'd have to say my favorite horror-esque movies are definitely the Saw movies.
Yeah, those are psychological. Those are different. Especially the first three.
I'm not as big into
I think they count.
Yeah, I love them. I love them.
Or into, like, the slashers, but I do definitely love, like, the visceralness and sort of the rabbit hole that the story goes down.
Oh, yeah.
How it isn't presented in a straight line.
Oh, yeah.
I love it. I love it. It gets my. I watched them. So the first time I watched, started watching the Saw movies, I was living actually with my ex's ex, and he told me, "Look, watch them," and then I was like, "Hey, wait, this goes in place here," and he's like, "Yeah, now you're getting it." And I was like, "Dang, man!"
When I was saying it was psychological, I wasn't gapping on it. I love Saw. It's something I usually watch every Halloween. I was pointing out that the reason I love it so much is because it messes with your head. It's not your typical slasher. It's not your typical this or that. It's so different than
it's its own special thing.
Yeah, and that's why I love it. Now, I don't really talk about the other ones, but I will say the first three, perfect. I love the first
three. Yep.
Dave, what's your favorite kids' Halloween-y movie or even horror movie?
Well, when I was a kid, I believe the movie is called Invasion of the Body Snatchers. I watched it recently.
Classic.
Yep. And as far as, like, an everyday thing, I'd say any of the earlier Halloween movies. Michael Myers.
Oh, yeah.
Ain't go wrong with classic.
The last one actually wasn't that bad. I believe
everyone
it was the last one.
Is entitled to at least one good scare. You gotta love Michael.
Oh, yeah.
So, my favorite, aside from the Halloween with Sarah, is I love my babysitter, not my babysitter, my mom's dating a vampire. I loved that.
Oh, movie. That was such a good one.
Oh, yeah. That's
it had that guy from the nanny in it, and yes,
I love him. I love him so much.
Another good one was Hocus Pocus. And I did like the
sequel. Oh, yeah.
I liked the sequel, Hocus Pocus. And I would love a prequel. If they didn't make it woke and shit, I would love a prequel series showing the sisters.
They're making another one.
They are making a third. They are.
Yeah.
But I want a prequel series. That would be awesome. As far as modern day horror, well, not modern day horror, but what I watch now on Halloween, I get a lot of flack for this. Halloween's probably my favorite franchise. I do like Chucky. Friday the 13th is okay, the first four. After that, it just sucks. And even then, there's not really anything tangible to grab. Michael's story is complex. Jason's story is just whatever. I love Friday the Nightmare on Elm Street. That one's a really good one. That's a classic. But with the Halloween franchise, I you know, y'all heard me earlier. I talked about how I liked Halloween 3. You know, I do not like Halloween 2 Rob Zombie. I do not like the second one. That's trash. But the very first Halloween Rob Zombie film, I have to watch every Halloween. It's got the gore, it's got the atmosphere. I think it's a solid Halloween movie. Do I consider it canon? Absolutely not. It's just something to watch at Halloween. It's crazy. I really liked that. And I know a lot of people are going to come at me. Just bear in mind, I don't consider it canon. My timeline is the original Halloween, Halloween 2, then Halloween 4, 5, and 6. And then that's kind of how it goes. And then probably Halloween H2O is how it ends. I did like the new ones, like what he was talking about. I even liked Halloween Kills. Just Halloween Ends. I'm going to have to rewatch all of them back to back. I don't know which timeline to go with as the story I like and consider canon. But.
Mm-hmm.
I love Conjuring. I love Dracula. Christopher Lee was a great Dracula. There was something recently I watched by John Carpenter, the guy who made Halloween, called Vampires. That was good. I watched that for the first time. That was really good. I like The Exorcist. There's so many good spooky movies. Just a lot of good stuff, especially on HBO Max and Tubi TV. I highly recommend.
There's a lot of good spooky TV shows out there as well. I mean, you got like Stranger Things, you got Supernatural. There's one that I really enjoyed that was called Grimm. I really enjoyed that show too.
Yeah. So
there's lots of good types of spooky stuff out there, not just movies.
I liked American Horror Story. I really liked that.
That's good too.
I mentioned that earlier. Now, I've only seen the first two seasons 100%, but I started watching season three. I want to watch all of it. It's just right now I just started, I guess since she mentioned it, I want to let everyone know I started watching Supernatural. So that's going to be quite a journey. I wanted to go see Beetlejuice too. That's not horror, but that's just...
I wanted to see that. I didn't get a chance to. I think we're going to try and rent it as soon as it comes out. But I really wanted to see that.
I'll let you know the last if it pops horror... up on a service.
Yeah, let me know. Oh, no, I'll see you.
Dave?
He left us.
I got to do it before Forrest does.
Actually, it's got to
be Dave!
You were my brother, Anakin! I loved you.
Well, we were getting too spooky for Dave.
Well, to be fair, he is in the middle of a hurricane, so.
You're right. Well, guys, it's about that time anyway. We told y'all some of our favorite candies. We told you our favorite stories. This was a longer podcast than usual. I don't know how long it came out to, but I hope you enjoyed it. Hope you enjoyed the phlegm, making a cameo, and all that good stuff.
I love it.
Hopefully y'all enjoyed it. Just keep on the lookout. This coming month, we have even more podcasts coming. So much more stuff. We are going to slow down. I know so much stuff came out this month. Probably not as much as I wanted because obviously I got a cold a little bit. But there's still a lot of good stuff. I mean, from the stuff with Chozo to the alien, there's just so many other things. So I don't know exactly what actually came out at the end, at the time of recording this, but I hope y'all enjoyed it. And I hope you're ready for the next month, because even though we're not coming out with as much, we still got Double Exposure, we still got the double, you know, the Life is Strange unboxing, we still got, I mean, a lot of good stuff, and we're going to be coming out with two pods every month going forward, maybe even more, so it's going to be a ride. So I hope you enjoyed the spooky season. I hope this was, you know, a very enjoyable October for everyone. And I hope you enjoyed the pod. Comment down below some of your favorite stuff, your answers in the comments. Leave a like if you enjoyed our pod. And until next time, keep the attitude and keep it scary.
Happy Halloween.